So let's have a quick recap of what we have done. We want to scrap this page. We need the text. We need the author. And we need the tags. So what we have done is, using Scrapy shell, we have created the complete selectors, as well as determined whether we use get method or we will be using get all method. So now we are ready to create our first spider. So let's open another command prompt and run the command scrapy gen spider. Now this gen spider command expects two parameters. Number one, name of the spider. You can have any name, doesn't matter. And then the second parameter should be the domain or the start URL. So let's copy this URL and paste it here. But there is one thing to be noted, that Scrapy is going to add HTTP. So let's remove it from here and press enter. And we have a message that created spider using a basic template. At this point, if we look at the directory structure, we can see that codes.py file has been created. So let's open Visual Studio Code and this file. So this is our first spider using the basic template. So it has created one code spider class, which inherits scrapy.spider class, and it has three attributes and one method. So the first attribute is name, which is exactly the same name that we gave on the command prompt. Allowed domain is not really useful at this moment, so I'm going to delete it. As we work with complex spider, it will become useful. For now, no. And start URL. So this start URL is the second parameter that we gave. And remember that we did not provide HTTP and it has added HTTP. If you paste in HTTP, it will become HTTP two times and this URL will become invalid. So that is something you need to keep in mind. And of course, if the URL that you are scraping is HTTPS, you'll have to put S here. Now, this is about the attributes. And then we have a parse method. Now, this is a special method. Now, this method is a callback method. So this method is automatically called when response is ready. So when we run the spider will go and go to this URL, connect, get the response, and when the response is ready, this function will be called. Side note, Visual Studio Code is not able to locate the correct environment, so that's why we see these lines. So we can just click on the bottom and choose the correct environment. Let's start writing our code with something very simple. We will print response and let's print response.url and let's add one message, response from. So this is a very simple message, got response from response.url. So when we run this, we will see what exact URL was called. So let's go back to the command prompt, clear everything out. And this time we are going to run a different command of Scrapy. The command is run spider. And run spider takes one parameter, which is the file name. Now, if I press enter, we will see a lot of log messages. Okay, we have one 404 error. There is something wrong with this URL. So I'm going to press control and click it. So this is what happened. When we pasted in the URL in Scrapy gen spider command, Scrapy added http://, at the beginning, and it added one slash at the end of the URL. Now this is what actually caused this to break. That is why I actually prefer to write my URLs after the spider has been generated. I'll show this later in the video, but for now, let's just correct the URL here and run the spider again. Clear everything. Same command. Okay, so we have a 200 message, and this is where our print is got response from this particular URL. Now, actually, print is not a good way to have custom messages when you are running a spider, because all these messages that you see here whenever we are running the spider are log messages. So we should also be using a log message. So if you want to use a log message, it's very simple. Instead of print, we will just say self.log. Very, very simple. So if we say self.log, let's see what changes. Clear, run the spider again. So this time we still have our message, but now this is a proper log message. I understand that initially when you just start with Scrapy, things look very messy and it becomes very difficult to understand this log message. But as you move along, it will become a lifesaver for you. You will get a lot of information, a lot of useful information. So let's try to get comfortable with this, all this logging. So let's see how spiders can return information. Spiders can return a dictionary. So let's create a dictionary. Let's call it item, and it will have author, and it will have the quote, and then finally it will have the tags. So this is the information. This is one dictionary that we will be creating. So finally we will return this dictionary using the yield statement. So let's copy paste this. Where is our author? This is the author. So let's copy and paste it here. And then we need the text of the actual quotation, which is here. And we need the tags. So this is here. So our first spider is ready. So let's go ahead and run it. Clear everything. Let's run it. Here, you will see that this is our dictionary, which is actually the data that we needed. We have the author, we have the actual quote, and we have the tags. In this particular case, it is only one tag. Let's run it again. So this time we can see that we have a different quote from a different person, and this time there are multiple tags. Now, because this becomes very tedious to read from the logs, let's save this output. And saving output in Scrapy is very easy. All we need to do is provide the dash o switch, and we can have CSV or JSON file created. So let's call it output.json. We can see that there is an output.json file created. Let's open this. So, and let's quickly format it. And we can see that there is author, there is quote, and there are tags. So this was our first spider. Now here is one exercise for you. Go to a Wikipedia page. I've taken Python programming language page, but you can take any page that you want. And what you need to do is you need to get this table of contents. So this will be your exercise. And if you want to see the result, go to the next one.